Thank you, Mr. President. I seek leave to make a brief explanation before addressing a question without notice to the Minister for Regional Development on the topic of regional bank closures.
Leave is granted.
Thank you, Mr. President. Data from the Australian Prudential Regulation Authority has shown that the number of bank branches in South Australia has dropped from 421 in 2017 to just 127 in 2022. People living in the Limestone Coast, Murray and Marley regions, the Eyre Peninsula, Lower North, York Peninsula and Mid-North regions have all been affected by bank closures. On the 12th of May, the CEO of Kingston District Council, Nat Traeger, spoke to InDaily about the effect of bank closures on regional communities and stated that, and I quote from the article, "The effect of bank closures on businesses in our township means that these businesses are unnecessarily exposed to overnight cash and security risks as they are unable to deposit their takings into a secure deposit facility. In many cases, the business owners will have to travel long distances and several hours with large sums of money exposed to unnecessary travel and security risks to deposit their takings at a major service hub that has a banking service. This is untenable for business owners." InDaily also reported that in the Mid-Murray region, some businesses are losing a day of trade, having to travel long distances to make deposits. On the 8th of March this year, the Legislative Council passed a motion initiated by the Greens, recognising the impact of the closure of banks on regional communities, and in particular, the impediment that this places on community and business activity. The motion called on the Malinauskas government to formally raise the closure of the Coober Pedy Bank with Westpac and to advocate for the retention of bank branches in the regions. My question to the minister is, has the minister formally raised the matter with Westpac, and what action has the minister and the government taken to protect regional communities from bank closures since this motion passed the Legislative Council 2 months ago?
Well, the Minister for Primary Industries and Regional Development.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I thank the honourable member for his question. I'd also like to congratulate Nat Traeger and all those involved with campaigning in regards to the bank in Kingston. As the honourable member has alluded to, the difficulties experienced by not only regional residents but regional businesses are considerable when indeed they do need to travel long distances, potentially with cash on them, and also the inconveniences that that has. I'm fairly confident I've mentioned this place earlier, possibly in response to the motion that the honourable member referred to that was passed on the 8th of March, that our government was writing to the national, the federal parliament's investigation into regional banking. And that certainly occurred. Both myself and the Treasurer worked together with our departments to be able to put in a submission to that. Now, it was really quite interesting in that when I looked at a list of the submissions that were made, I'm very sad to say I couldn't see any submissions made by those opposite. I couldn't see any submissions to that national inquiry from the opposition here in terms of regional banking, despite what they have said in this chamber about its importance. Now, I didn't see anything from the Honourable David Spears, I didn't see anything from the Honourable Nicola Santofanti or anything under the heading of Liberal opposition in South Australia. Now, if indeed there was a submission made under some other name, then certainly I'd be happy to be advised of that. But I think it is disappointing that, despite a lot of noise made from those opposite, they apparently have not bothered to take the time to put those towards the federal inquiry, because of course the federal inquiry is looking at regional banking across the board, is able to hear about individual regions or individual towns most affected, but is trying to look at solutions that would apply across the country. So that is the action that I have taken in that regard.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Mr. Sims.
In addition to making a submission, has the Minister written to Westpac, and if not, why not?
Minister.
Thank you. I've written to the investigation nationally, and Interestingly, I did also see, I couldn't see anything from the Greens to that national inquiry either. I'm happy to be corrected if the State Greens have made a submission as well. But I think it would have been really quite meaningful if all of us in this place, both from opposition and crossbench and the government, had made a submission, because it was certainly something that was raised a number of times in this place.
Why hasn't the minister taken action following the resolution of this council? Why hasn't she written to Westpac? That was what this council directed, Mr. President.
Minister.
I've outlined the action that I have taken.